So for the last two, I want you to use what is known as Pathfinder to manipulate these last two letter forms. Now, you can tell I'm still using the same typeface. I don't care if you use the same typeface, just as long as all of your icons are different and done in the with the tools and in the manner that I ask you to do them. But as far as Pathfinder goes, let's bring that up. Pathfinder is right here in my palette. Okay. I'm going to take this Pathfinder and drag it out so you guys can see it more clearly. Okay. Pathfinder is a great tool. It allows me to use objects, multiple objects, to create or to edit other objects. So for example, you see this one has two rectangles by it, kind of being combined or united to create this funky shape. Okay. This one has two rectangles together where it shows the front one being cut out from the back one. Okay. And then this one, this has two rectangles where you use both of those rectangles to keep this overlapping shape. Okay. And then this one right here excludes where they overlap. So let me show you what that is actually doing with the Pathfinder. I'll just use the rectangles like they did. Okay, there's a rectangle there, and there's a second rectangle there. All right, now notice that they are still two rectangles. I can move them independently of each other. All right, but if I take both of those rectangles and select them both and hit this first unite option, it will melt those two, or basically unite those two rectangles into one. So I'll click that, and now you can see they're one whole object. Those little lines where they overlapped, those old boundaries of the rectangles aren't there anymore. Okay. Now let's do the second one. I'll overlap them like they are in the example, and I'll hit minus front. So what's going to happen if I hit minus front? Well, I click on it, and the front one subtracted itself out of the back one. So that piece is actually missing from the rectangle. So you can create complex shapes using Pathfinder by basically using overlapping or other simple shapes to create more complex shapes. All right, I think I said that backwards around and all sorts of ways that hopefully it made sense. But let's do the second one. I'll undo that, undo all of my movement there. Okay, let's do the third one, which is intersect. Okay, it only kept the pieces where those two intersected, and the third one will delete where they intersect. Okay, so you can see it's actually transparent now. So we can, you know, now we have this tool, Pathfinder, that we can use to create these more complex shapes. So if I take a circle and I want to cut out, you know, a piece of this rectangle with the circle, I just draw a circle, select them both, and hit minus front. All right. So that's what we're going to use. These other ones are also an option right here. If I take this last one here, and that actually divides them all. So what that does, I'm sorry, I'm getting a little discombobulated. People are trying to contact me. But what this does, and I don't have time to edit all this stuff out right now. But what this does is it actually divides it. If I take my white arrow tool, you'll see that it chopped itself all up. Or I can ungroup it, because it stays grouped once you hit the divide button. And I could color different the pieces differently. Okay, so that was divide. All right, so we're going to use Pathfinder for the last two examples. With this first one, what I want you to do is actually take a second letter form and combine it and use a second letter form to manipulate this one. So I'll take a letter P. And outline it. Type create outlines. All right. And overlay it in a manner that's interesting. Okay. We'll go for that right now, I think. That's fine. And now I can take both of these letter forms and I can hit unite, and that just melted them all together, right? So that they're just one object, and I can make it a single color that way. Or I can hit minus front, so it deleted that letter form out of the back letter form. Now, you can't really see a P there, but I'm going to leave that up to you. You don't necessarily have to see that other letter form in its entirety mixed in with this. I'll just leave that up to you. I can hit overlap and only keep where it's overlapping. Now that's really abstract. And then delete where the places where they overlap. Okay, I might have said that backwards. This one only kept where they intersected. This one deleted where they intersected. Okay. If you try the divide option right here, they chop each other up. And you can take the direct select tool and kind of move some of those pieces around if you like. Excuse me. go a little crazy. Just remember, when you use those letter forms to divide each other, they stay grouped. So if you want to separate them, you have to ungroup them right here, or take your direct select and grab each piece with your direct select. Okay. So divide is pretty cool, actually. You can do quite, divide's nice because it lets you keep all the pieces and then you can manipulate them or move them how you want. But do something really cool with that using another letter form and Pathfinder. This one, I want the very last one, I want you to use Pathfinder, but I want you to use a regular shape for the other shape. So quite quickly, I'll finish up this video really quickly. I'll do a circle. And then come over here, select them both, and just do minus. Let's do just divide for now. Ungroup it. Okay. And here is my shape combined with my letter form. I used another shape to manipulate that letter form. Okay? So this is what I want you to do for the last two. Use Pathfinder. But for this one, use another letter form to manipulate and create something interesting and new. This one, use a shape with the letter form and create something interesting and cool, unique, creative, however you want to put it. Oh, and by the way, just remember that if you guys don't like the grades that you get, you guys can contact me, and you can always rework your stuff, add detail, make it better, and I will look at it and see if I can give you a better grade. You can always rework your stuff. All right. That's it. So do these letter forms, create these icons. I'll have you save this as a PDF and upload it for me for this assignment. So file, save as, PDF, and hand this Illustrator PDF in.